Hey there everyone, in this quick tutorial I'll show you how I made this custom slider design using the slides widget in Elementor Pro and some custom CSS. What's cool is that this slider remains completely responsive and adjusts perfectly to any screen size and any page scale. You can easily change the color and size of the arrows, move them around and modify this code in the way you want. The standard Elementor Pro slides widget doesn't give you many options to have fun with, so you can't create a slider like this one or this one, which by the way were the source of inspiration for this particular design. So whether you're using Elementor Pro or even some third-party Elementor add-on, you'll be able to modify any slider with this simple trick. You can find the code snippet in the comments section down below, but before you copy and paste it on your own page, let's have a closer look at how it works and what it does so you can customize it and change it to match your own page design. I started out by dropping the slides widget on a new section, and in this tutorial I show you how to set up a full page slider, and if you want to have it in a column layouts like over here, we'll get back to it at the end of the video. After adding the slides widget, I deleted all the content from the slides so we can focus solely on the navigation part. Let's dive right in. So now we'll be looking at how we can change the way these arrows look and apply some styles to them using custom CSS. And as you know, to target a specific element in your widget, you gotta go and grab the class of this element. So I published this page and went to preview. So here in the preview, I can press F12 or just right click and click inspect. So I can see the source code of this page, and I wanna grab the inspect tool and hover over this arrow over here. So here it automatically chooses the before, the pseudo element, but we need the arrow itself. And if you go down here to the styles tab, we can copy this entire thing here, and these are the classes of both of these arrows. As you can see, they are selected here on the left, which means that we have selected both of these at the same time. So I'll just copy this line of code and get back to my Elementor editor and simply drop the copied code over here and open the curly brackets. And here I can finally start writing some code, some styles for our arrows. I'm gonna go with white for this tutorial, but you can change it to any other color. So now I would also give the height and the width for our arrows. This will be the width and the height of the container itself. It doesn't affect the size of the arrows. You can change the size of the arrows back there in the styles tab. Now we're only changing the size of the container. I'm using percent over here because now we're writing the styles for the desktop. And as you know, monitors can be of different size, and also the users can have a different scale in their browser. This is why it's important to make sure that the size of this entire slider and each element inside the slider is going to adjust to the size of the page and to the size of the window open in the browser, etc. Yep, this is why we're doing that. Now, let's move it down a little bit since we want our arrows, both of them, to sit in the right-hand bottom corner. Since our arrows here have the position absolute, it's written inside the source code for these arrows, and you can see it if you use it, the inspector. And now we will just move these arrows down, and 96% seems pretty good. You can go for 93. Also fine. By the way, there might be a tiny problem, and let's address it right away. When using percents, when moving your elements with absolute position, this is what you might get. This might turn into a problem if the arrow's background, or maybe the section background in which the slider sits, is of a different color. You will clearly see that these elements overlap. It's not looking really good, unless you want to make them overlap that way. This is why I need to fine-tune this percentage, so be careful with that. So now I'll switch it back to white, and we're pretty much done. These styles apply to both of these arrows, because you see here we have both of these arrows targeted, separated by a comma. And if we jump down a little bit and we pick only one of these two arrows, so let's start with here will be the right arrow, the next arrow, and over here first there will be the previous arrow, and then we'll start with the previous arrow. So what we need to do is to move it to the right. Okay, let's first, let's first move the second arrow. What we need to do here is to move it to the right edge, so it sticks right to the edge of our slider. This is why what we need to do, remembering that this arrow also has the position absolute. And we can move this element by using right, left, top, and bottom properties. And if we simply write that on the right, this element is going to have 0% of pixels or of anything, 0% of extra space. So it's going to stick to our right edge. So now we have to move the second arrow. So it is kind of attached to the first arrow, well, to the next arrow. All right. What we're going to do here is we're going to use the left property and say 90%, and we cannot see it for now because it is sort of behind the other arrow. And to move it to the edge of the first arrow, to kind of make them sit together next to each other, we're going to use the negative margin. We're going to say margin left and say minus 10%. And this is gonna make this arrow jump on the left side of our first arrow. So this is what it looks like so far, and we can update the page and go and check it out on the preview. So this is what it looks like. And if we open the inspector again, and if we want to move, trying to resize this page, this is what it's gonna look like. So this is kind of how this would look on a tablet, and I don't really like how this arrows shrink down. It's very easy to fix if you go back and write some styles for the tablet device, but on mobile it's going to look something like this. Of course, we're going to change the height of the slider and it's going to look better. But anyways, remembering that the minimum touch target is actually 40 pixels on mobile devices, it's not going to be very usable, and well, it's going to take up a lot of space over here, and some users might even miss these arrows or maybe interpret them in a wrong way. This is why it is safer to simply place these arrows on the sides. How are we going to approach adapting this design to tablet devices and mobile devices? Let's have a look. So, since we have this piece of code written here, I'm going to use the media query to say that this code written over here is going to only work for the screen size bigger than 996 pixels. There we go. And now we need to open a new curly bracket and go to the very end of our code snippet and then close the bracket. As you see, it turned green. It means that all the code that is inside these two curly brackets is only going to work when the width of your window in which this page with the slider is open is more than 996 pixels. This is how it works. All right, let's quickly see if it actually worked. Once the width of the page is smaller than, well, than said 996 pixels, the arrows turn back to normal. Now, what we need to do? We need to retain that background color of our arrows and slightly tweak the position of these arrows. Now let's see what we need to change. Well, as you remember, the only value that is not going to change across all of the devices will be the background color. It's still gonna be white in my case. Well, of course you can use different colors, you remember. So I'm gonna copy it over here. Don't forget to close the curly bracket. Now I'm writing the styles for the tablet device. So I want to make the size of these arrows, I mean the container of the arrow, fixed. I don't want the value to be in percents. I would rather use pixels, because for mobile devices and tablet devices, it is important that you retain the size of your elements around the minimum to average touch target size, which is on mobile devices, not less than 40 pixels. It's important to remember. And I want their size to be 70 pixels. All right, and just to make sure, I want to use the top property and say 50% to move them to the middle of our slider. All right, we cannot really see the result over here. And to disable this portion of code written here, we could use two slashes. And now we have only this portion of code working. Now let's keep writing the styles for our arrows separately. So we will target both of these one by one. So start with this arrow. What we need to do is to move it to the edge, because I want it to be really close to the edge. I want it to stick it right to the edge over here. And I'm going to say left 0%. Here I'm going to do the same, but move it to the right edge. And I'm going to say right also 0%. Okay, it is done. Now, what we want to do is to write the styles for the mobile device. Finally and lastly, this will be the last thing we need to change. And I'm going to use the media query again and say media. But this time I'm going to use not minimum width, but maximum width, which will be 480 pixels. Again, open the green curly brackets, and I'm going to copy these classes separated by a comma. We're going to target both of these arrows again. And the only thing we're going to change is the size of our arrow containers. Because as you remember, the touch target on the mobile device has to be 40 pixels minimum, but we shouldn't make them too large so they don't take up too much space covering some other elements and just ruining the design of the slider and ruining the look of the page. This is why we're gonna simply say width 50 pixels and height 50 pixels as well. Now let's remove these two slashes over here. And while we're pretty much done, let's update the page and jump to the preview to see the result. There it is. Here we have our arrows. So after you've done setting up the code part, we can adjust the slider to your layout design. Change the slider height for tablet and mobile devices, or move it over to a two-column layout, which will only require some minor changes of the button width parameters. And that was it for this quick tip for Elementor Pro Slides widget. If you like this video and want to see more tutorials like this one, let us know in the comment section down below. Besides that, feel free to leave your requests and suggestions for the following videos. We have tutorials and all sorts of educational and inspirational videos posted every week, so we would be excited to hear your thoughts and ideas. On that note, thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Stay safe and take care.